Way of description. We wanted to go now for the second way of describing the process of wound healing. In the last presentation, we say that there is hematostasis. This will followed by inflammation, which will end up by granulation and remodeling, right? This is the procedure that the body will follow up until the wound. This is the procedure which is the body will follow up until the wound healing happen. Come back here to go for more analysis and deep. Let's here to go for more description of the progress of happening these stages of wound healing. Based on the physiology of the wound healing, let's to say that this is the wound. Directly when the wound happen, we will start by hematostasis. There will be blood coming all this area and fill all this area. This is the blood. So the wound care strategies on this phase, it will start by stop the bleeding. Maybe the blood will go out, so we are losing this blood, so we will go to stop this bleeding, and this will end by dryness happen in this area. This area will be dry, but this, the blood here will not be dry, rather than it will go for clot formation. It will start here to have so many clots. This also accompanied by messages from the tissues here. It will start to send messages for the body about happening of destruction in this area. And this destruction will stimulate the monocytes, which will start to go inside the wound and developing or modifying or call the macrophages. And this strategies of macrophages will start to clean up this area and accumulate here and send some growth factors. And remember this term in describing the progress of the wound healing. This growth factors will pass from macrophages, which start to be here to the body, and it will attract two things will happen on the same time. First one, a type of cells called fibroblasts. It will start to come here to the wound and start to produce a kind of intention, a kind of tension, or a kind of making the wounds going for closing by producing the connective tissue. And this fibroblast will produce collagen. And this collagen will accelerate filling up the gap of this wound. Also, this fibroblast will start to destroy these blood clots and replaced by connective tissue with collagen. And this process also will be combined by the other stimulation happen from the growth factor, which is building in new blood vessels, which is known as angiogenesis or angioneogenesis. To start here to produce these capillaries, and this capillaries will start to build a way or matrix of blood in the wound, vessels in the wound, and this will enhance building a new tissues, and this will start to fill the wounds by new tissues. On the same time, there is something will happen here, which is the endothels, the epithelium, start to jump in the wound, in the frog stem, to close this area until this area from upstairs will be closed. In some cases, there will be hypertrophy will happen here, and this will be like colloids or something, but this is apart from the abnormalities, let's say theoretically. This process will stop by touching the epithelium from both sides with the new cells from the other sides. This is how the wounds already progressing and happening in a simple way, that in a simple way that enhance the best fill of tissues and the granulation until this happening of the healing. However, what are the possibilities of having problems? Plenty of problems can happen. Within the methods of having the wound, that within the hematostasis, when there is so much amount of blood here and the fluids, there is possibilities that the bacteria start to enter inside the wound. Different types of microorganisms, mainly the epiderms, staphyloepiderms, and this will give good media for the bacteria to start to have multiplication, to have increased in the number of bacteria that will come in. And this will lead for wound infection. The problem is not starting here. Rather than with coming the microphages, monocytes coming in, and this with a stimulation for the B cells to bring these antibodies, it will combined by this amount of bacteria to produce massive enzymes that will help the body to clean up this process. As we said in the last vlog, that inflammation, it's leading for the cleaning. This is the meaning of the inflammation. So those white blood cells would like to reduce this amount of bacteria here, and this will stimulate making a type of enzyme called as matrix metalloproteases, which is known as MMP. The purpose of MMP, it's supporting the white blood cells in destroying the bacteria. But with the chronicity, with inability of the fibroblast and all this process to make this wound closed, these MMPs will start to accumulate in the wound. And this accumulation will even stop the collagen production from the fibroblast. And this will lead also for chronicity of the wound. So, as apart from the chronic wounds, which the pressure ulcer example of it, this is our concern, the characteristic of chronic wounds is having high piece. Okay, remember this way, as increase the amount of MMPs, as an example from the chronicity in the wound care, and there are several characteristics related to the chronic wounds that will lead for long healing time. So the management is also affected by the way that we are perceiving the physiological changes happen in the wound. So we'll come back now for the wound bed preparation. In the wound bed preparation, our concern our concern here, it's providing the proper way of dealing with the wounds, most focused toward the chronic wounds, and they are classifying the wounds to three types: healable wounds, non-healable wounds, and stagnated wounds, or something in the middle. Healable, that mean even these wounds are chronic, we are able to reach the closure of the wound. So the management here will be a little bit different. Non-healable wounds, for several chronicity factors, this wound are the ability of the granulation to fill up these wounds are still long dream. And the concern of practitioner of the wound care to at least not make the wound progress harder, not to reach several not to promote the quality of life of the patient, to enhance that the wounds will not getting to be much more worse, to be worst. Okay. And there are the stagnated or wounds on the middle, where the wound can be healed, but there are other factors that we need to take it in consideration before going for healing. As we discussed in the first part here, when we come to the wound that we would like this wound to be closed, we are need for fibroblast, and this fibroblast will attract the stem cell, and this stem cells all will produce granulation and collagen. And the collagen is apart from protein, so the nutrition of the patient can be reasons for stop the healing. Again, this process all will be in need for blood supply. So if the wound did not have a proper blood supply, so the wounds will not be healed, and so on. So stagnated wounds, or wounds in the middle between healable and non-healable, are a type of the wounds that need factors from outside the system of the wounds that will support the healing of those. Until this level, we are describing the categories of the wound, but we did not still mention the time principles. So, when we come to the time principle